Islam. Today we'll be addressing the United States participation with the International Criminal Court. American Bar Association put out a kind of like a notice, the section of international law, section of criminal justice report to the House of Delegates, recommendation urging the United States government to expand and broaden United States interaction with the International Criminal Court. In this, it speaks of Bill Clinton signing on to the Rome Statute and backing out of it, same as the Bush administration. They made bilateral agreements and telling other people that if they did not sign a certain agreement which agrees to not send American citizens and U.S. soldiers to the International Criminal Court, if they was convicted of human rights violations, genocide, all that. And they would cut off aid to the countries that refused to sign that agreement. And the International Criminal Court is aware of this. The report supports a resolution to be presented on the August 2008 meeting. So since 2008, it also states that the for 6 years the U.S. seats at meetings of the ASP, the ICC's governing body, have been empty. 6 years. Also, like I said before, President Clinton signed the Rome Statute on December 31st, 2000, but at the same time said the Rome Statute should not be submitted to the Senate for ratification. In May 2002, they've been, but first, as far as Clinton, he said he did not want to submit it to the Senate for ratification due to concerns that the court does not provide sufficient protection from politicized persecution or prosecution. So if they violate human rights, they don't want to politicize the prosecution of it. The same as the recently a teenage girl was shot to death by sheriff deputies in Kentucky, and they refused to give the identities of the sheriff deputies. In 2002, the Bush administration informed the UN Secretary General of the U.S. intention not to ratify the Rome Statute, withdrawing the U.S. signature of the Rome Statute. This is showing clearly that they do not wish to reach peace. You know, they're not wanting to cooperate with the International Criminal Court after they've already signed and they're obligated. See, the Rome Statute and International Criminal Court, we're not obligated. I have not signed anything. However, they have, so they're obligated to that. That's not the law that's used. However, it is obligations that they must answer to. The legislative basis for the anti-ICC policy is a statute called the American Service Members Protection Act, passed in early 2002, just before the Rome Statute entered into force with the 60th ratification. It authorizes cutoffs of military and military assistance for any country that fails to provide satisfactory assurance to the United States that the country will not extradite or otherwise transfer a U.S. citizen to the International Criminal Court. A separate piece of anti-ICC legislation referred to as the Nethercutt Amendment to Annual Foreign Operations. U.S. embarked on a global diplomatic campaign to press member states to sign non-delivery agreements, referred to variously as Article 98 agreement or bilateral immunity agreement. Signing a BIA was presented as a condition of receiving some forms of American economic or military assistance. Now also, U.S. effectively acknowledged that the ICC has an important role in stopping impunity for the worst international crimes. See, it says also that the court is an independent treaty-based permanent judicial institution with jurisdiction over individuals for genocide, war crimes, and crimes against humanity. Its jurisdiction is complementary to national courts, which means that the ICC can only proceed when a national court is unwilling or unable to hear the case. Now, when I read that, it reminded me of the Great Seal Moore Science Temple of America, Inc., versus State of New Jersey, Asbury Park Police Department, Sergeant John Broyles, Richards Auto Body. So it says this jurisdiction is complementary to national courts, which means that the ICC can only proceed when a national court is unwilling or unable to hear the case. This is the case involving Brother Nature and Brother Times. And it does, and it speaks in here that it speaks of jurisdiction of law. The Wall Township Police Department Sergeant Lance Lotta and Sergeant Brockley's motion to dismiss for lack of jurisdiction. No, it's this was a writ of and a writ of error was filed immediately after this. So, once again, the American Bar Association Section of International Law Section of Criminal Justice report to the House of Delegates. This is the American Bar Association speaking of the United States failure to honor their obligations and to cooperate with the International Criminal Court, Islam.